In my last very good video, which you should definitely go and watch after you finished this one, I was pretty rude about AI upscaling. And the only downside of the upscaling is some slight smearing, but I'm sure you can't tell. Which, now that I've had some time to think about it, feels a little bit uncalled for a couple of reasons. The first one is, while making that video, I realized that some graphics technologies take really long to mature to a point where they're usable in the day-to-day world. And the second thing is, I haven't actually tried DLSS 4 yet. And at least, according to Nvidia, it is a lot better. So in today's video, we're gonna try it so that we can fairly be rude about it. Now, I gotta give it to Nvidia. One of the cool things about DLSS 4 is that you can use most of the features with older Nvidia graphics cards. And considering that I wasn't cool enough to get a 5090 to do a video on, which I'm not sour about at all.
I wish I was cool.
I have to use a 40 series graphics card for this video, but I think that's an interesting test to see how well that technology works on an older GPU. So in this system, I've got a low profile RTX 4060, which it's actually a use case that I think makes more sense. Using AI upscaling on the fastest graphics card in the world is a bit like doing penis enlargement on a horse. It's just not the correct use case. But it makes sense on slower systems to get them to do a little bit more than their cut down GPU NIS is supposed to be able to handle. So I've got a 4060 in here. And as far as I know, there should be a Cyberpunk update. Now, before we have a look at the first game to get DLSS 4, Cyberpunk, I will say that even its older implementation of DLSS was pretty good. It was by no means the worst offender. When I'm complaining about upscaling, I'm usually complaining about Unreal Engine 5 games. I mean, this is what Stalker's DLSS looks like on balanced. I mean, I get that my character's drunk and irradiated, but that is some wild smearing. But we'll see if we can get the new DLSS running on that a bit later. First, let's give Cyberpunk a try. Now, when you first launch the patched Cyberpunk, you're greeted with a new DLSS setting, choosing between a convolutional, which is the previous model, and the new transformer model. Now, the differences between these two seem very complicated, but according to Geeks for Geeks, transformer models are more effective in situations that have large data sets and need global context. And by global, they mean the entire image, which, you know, that sounds fair enough for upscaling, I guess. Let's see what it looks like. And in terms of settings, we're starting at 1440p medium with no DLSS. This is a good looking image. There is a little bit of latency. It doesn't feel amazing, but it's running at 60 frames per second. It feels how you would imagine 60 frames per second to feel. I mean, one of the immediate takeaways is that you can just tell that there's no upscaling going on, because when there's a bunch of movement, you're not losing detail on things like the asphalt and whatever, and there isn't any trailing happening behind our car. That's one of the places where it shows up the most clearly, is you get this kind of like ghost after image behind the vehicle, especially when it's quite high contrast. Now for DLSS, let's start off with the non-aggressive quality setting on the old model. When the camera is static, when it comes to just the detail on the road, it's nice and sharp, but you can see there's a little bit of a blurring going on when there's movement. And I've turned motion blur off. This wasn't here when we were running natively at 1440p. So that's something. Although, I mean, it's not huge. It's like a slightly blurrier road. But luckily, at these settings, we aren't really getting that after. Oh, no, it is there a little bit. But honestly, it looks pretty good. And we've gone from 60 frames per second to 90 frames per second, which is a big jump. The game feels a lot better. Just the general image when there's movement is just a little bit less sharp than it is with it running at not quality. We're gonna switch to transformer model. So this is the new version of DLSS, and apparently it's a lot better according to Nvidia. Now, straight off the bat, I mean, the road is sharp. Like, there's definitely better sharpness going on here. than there is with the previous model.
Now, I don't know how clear this is on the screen capture, so I've zoomed in a lot on a frame of movement over the asphalt. Now, remember, my editing software is doing its own upscaling and there's YouTube compression, so in real life, it looks different, but you can see there's a clear difference in sharpness, even at quality, which isn't particularly aggressive.
In terms of frame rate, it's about the same.
I then spent ages A-B-ing between native 1440p and the two versions of DLSS at quality. And even with these conservative settings, yeah, the new DLSS does look better.
It does look a lot better.
It manages to conserve sharpness while moving a lot better than the previous version of DLSS. But what happens when we start being a lot more aggressive with the upscaling?
I'm gonna go to balanced, which has gained us about 15 to 20 frames per second. I mean, at this point, balanced using the new model looks better than quality.
Like if we use the zoom inimatron on a still frame of movement, despite the new DLSS being at a more aggressive setting, it still preserves detail on the road better and detail on that cross pattern on the interior of the car. It seems to deal with aliasing better, which helps a lot. Then I decided to find a place to best see the difference in what I think is one of the biggest issues with these upscaling technologies, smearing. A problem that shows up worst with moving objects on a high contrast background. And the new DLSS does a really good job here. Even with performance settings, there isn't that much smearing here. You have to turn it up to ultra performance for it to get really obvious. Whereas with the old DLSS, even at balanced, you could notice it, which is a really impressive improvement. And then finally, in terms of cyberpunk, I did notice a weird artifact with both the new and old version of DLSS. Both of them have a real problem with smoke. Look at how low res that looks, even with higher settings on the new DLSS. Very interesting. But with that, let's move away from a game which even its older implementation of DLSS is pretty decent, to a much worse offender, Stalker 2. I'm not going to beat around the bush here. I couldn't get DLSS 4 running on Stalker 2 yet. Despite Nvidia saying that it's a day one title, it doesn't officially have DLSS 4 support yet. I guess day one is on the 30th, I'm not sure. But either way, I did find an apparent workaround to get new DLSS working on older DLSS games. Now basically how it works is you copy the DLL files from the latest Cyberpunk patch and drop it into the files in Stalker, for example, but apparently it works with a bunch of other games as well. The whole process is outlined in this Reddit post, which I'll have linked down below, but basically you use Nvidia profile injectors to edit some presets and stuff, and then it forces the new DLSS. And it even looks like the game thinks that it works, because you get a new DLSS option in Stalker 2's menu, the option for ray reconstruction, which is a DLSS 4 setting. The problem is, it doesn't look any different to me. Even with the updated files, the smearing and stuff is still really bad. I mean, this is running at 1080p, but it's just balanced. It's not even that aggressive a setting. Either way, it'll be resolved pretty soon when official support drops for it. At least I think it would, considering how much of a difference it made with Cyberpunk. And my lord, does Stalker's implementation need improvement, because it's a minimum requirement and looks terrible. On a final note, I also tried Silent Hill 2, which according to Nvidia is a day one DLSS 4 game that uses Unreal Engine 5, but that also didn't have settings for it. So with that, when Stalker 2 DLSS 4 support finally drops, I'll do a short comparing the difference between the two. But honestly, I'm really impressed with the improvement going from DLSS 3 to DLSS 4. Graphics technologies take time to mature, and this seems to be maturing pretty well at this point. But obviously, we'll keep evaluating it as it happens. So with that, thank you very much for watching. Let me know what your experiences are with DLSS 4 down below, and yeah, until the next video, bye-bye.